Hi, my name is Caroline, and in this video, I'll show you how I made this Raspberry Pi motion-triggered hand-washing timer that plays music and lights up an LED for 20 seconds. With COVID-19, health officials are recommending that we wash our hands often and for at least 20 seconds each time. To help myself wash my hands for 20 seconds, I made this motion-triggered musical timer and put it in my bathroom. In addition to lighting up an LED, there are 10 different songs that it randomly plays each time it is triggered. Now let's get started. I originally did this project with a Pi Moroni speaker hat, and after I completed the entire project, I realized that the speaker hat had been discontinued. Yikes. I started thinking about how I could do this project without a Pi Moroni speaker hat. My original project did two things during the 20 seconds. It played a song clip and it lit a display. Audio and visual elements were important to me. To replace the speaker hat, I'm using an LED for the visual and a speaker with a 3.5 millimeter jack for the audio. This brings me to the items you'll need for this project. The materials you'll need for this project are, I am using a Raspberry Pi 4. You can also use a Raspberry Pi 3. Along with your Raspberry Pi, you'll need a micro SD card formatted with the Raspbian operating system. Also for your Raspberry Pi, you'll need a mouse and keyboard, and this is the keyboard dongle. If you're using a Pi 4 like I am, you'll also need an HDMI monitor, and this is the dongle for the HDMI, and you'll also need a power cable to power up your Pi. Now, you'll also need a motion sensor. This is my motion sensor. It's a PIR motion sensor for the LEDs, or just LED, really. I have a small breadboard. I have a choice of LEDs. I'll only be using one of these. Of course, you can use any color that you would like. And then you'll also need a 330 ohm resistor. Now, this is the speaker that I am using. It has a 3.5 millimeter jack on the back, and it is powered, charged up with a micro USB. And thus, I have a male-to-male 3.5 millimeter audio cable to connect it to my Pi, and I also have a micro USB to charge and keep this speaker on. In terms of jumper wires, you'll need two male to female cables and three female to female cables. If you don't have female to female cables, what I did in this instance is I used six cables. I used three male to male and three male to female cables in this scenario. So there are a couple different ways you can do this, and those are the items you'll need for this project. Now let's start with the hardware assembly. Here's my Raspberry Pi 4, and I have my micro SD card formatted with the Raspberry Pi operating system, fresh copy here. For the Pi 4, I will need to insert this dongle for the HDMI monitor, and then I'll connect this to the HDMI monitor. For the mouse and keyboard, I've got a dongle, and I will insert that into my Raspberry Pi. Now, let's get to the breadboard with the LED. So this jumper cable is connected to the negative lead from the LED, and this jumper cable is connected to the resistor, and the resistor is connected to the positive lead of the LED. Now for the motion sensor, we will connect three female ends. There we go, wiring our PIR motion sensor. According to the wiring diagram, we're gonna start with ground. Bring ground over to pin six. Next is the out, which is pin number 11. Pin down on the left. And then last but not least, we need power, which is pin number two, first row. On the right, and that should be our PIR motion sensor. Next, let's wire up our LED. We are going to plug the positive end into pin number 8, and then the negative terminal of the resistor will go to ground, and the next available ground, or one of the available grounds, is pin number 14. And there we go. So if you want to look at a side view, now let's plug in our speaker. So this is a speaker, 3.5 millimeter jack, and then I will simply plug that in. And also to keep the speaker, my speaker is a micro USB speaker to keep it powered up. Micro USB cable, and to keep it charged up, just plug it right into the Pi. Last but not least, let's power up our Pi. And we're back. You should be able to see my screen now. This is my Raspberry Pi operating system desktop. I'll go ahead and open up a terminal. First thing I do, just good practice, is sudo apt get update. And I've already done this before I started this video, so it should go really quickly. There should not be any new updates. And then of course next is sudo apt get upgrade. Same thing, already ran this before I started this video, should be good to go. Next, let's open up my Chromium browser. Let's get to the GitHub, and we're gonna go to github.com/CarolineDunn. I will link to this, and then I go into repositories, and we're gonna choose hand washing timer LED. The original project is called hand washing timer music. We're using an LED this time, so it's hand washing timer LED. Click on that, and this gives us a little GIF that I put together. You can kind of see how it works with the little light that comes on. We've already been through the materials. Prerequisites, we're on Raspberry Pi OS. Hardware assembly, there's the entire schematic. And now we are up to step two, install software. First of all, we will sudo pip install python-vlc, copy that, take that over to my terminal, right click, paste, and we will sudo pip install python-vlc. Excellent, that is done. Next, we'll go and git clone my repository, copy and paste. And now we're copying over all of my files from my repository. And now we're going to cd into the repository we just cloned. Cd hand washing timer LED. Right click, paste, enter. And there it is. I'm going to ls to see my files. And the next step is to test some music out. Okay, with the command python test music ledpy. Now before we do that, there's one little thing we need to do, and we need to make sure that our speaker is connected properly. We're going to go to volume control. Left click, you just see the volume. If you right click, you'll see that it's on HDMI. You want to be on analog for this project. Hit analog, right click, analog, I'm there. And now let's see if we can Python test some music. Let's see if this works. Right click, paste, enter. And hopefully you can hear that. That is the music. And essentially what happens is that Python code test music LED, it picks a random song and it plays it. And now we have tested and made sure we can play a random song. Now the other thing you can test is to see if the LED lights up. And we do that, ls, there's a file called LED right here, so we can Python led.py, the light LED now turns off and on. So that's a great way to test out different LEDs, or just to see if you've wired up the LED. We've tested the LED, we've tested that it can play music. Now let's test out the motion sensor. I'm gonna hit Control C, get out of that, LS, and what is the script for the Python motion sensor? Is Python pir-led.py. Right click, copy, go back to our terminal, and I will right click, paste, and let's see if this works. This is a good sign. It says waiting for PIR to settle. Excellent, now it's ready. So I will pass my hand over this motion sensor. Oh, and there it goes. It picked a random song and the LED is on. And now it waits 30 seconds. So that way you're just not triggering it all of the time. There's 30 seconds in between each time you can trigger it. So I'm gonna turn down the volume just a little bit here. I'm gonna hit Control C because I want to stop this script. But hey, we've tested it out. It works great. Now let's go back to our GitHub page and see what's next. That was step two. Now we're gonna move on to step three. Now, so that we don't have to connect a terminal and a keyboard and a mouse to start this script every single time we turn it on, wouldn't it be easier if we just had it run on boot? There's an easy way of doing that. All we have to do is open a terminal, and we're gonna go into our bash file. We're gonna sudo nano into our bash file. And this is our bash file. I'm gonna arrow all the way down to the bottom of the file. And you want to add the command python home pi hand washing timer pir-led.py. Copy that. We're going to paste that down into the bottom of this file. Paste, enter, Control X, yes. Yes, I want to save this, enter, and now I can reboot. And there it goes. It works. On boot. And now you can unplug this, unplug the keyboard and mouse and everything, and put it in your bathroom and just power it up, and it works great. And there's my 20-second motion-triggered hand-washing timer with LED and music. If you want to replace the music with your own music, if you have the MP3, you can cut the song down to 20 seconds easily using a free program called Audacity. I'd recommend renaming your 20-second clips with the file names 1 through 10.mp3 and overwrite my music clips with your music clips in the music folder. I hope you enjoyed this project. I publish new tutorials every week. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye now.